gonna be a failure.
Don't say that.
Alright, so make sure we are logging into Google Classroom real quick. Open up the slide deck for unit 5 and hit up slide number 9. On top of that, go back to Classroom tab. There should also be another slide that was posted that says KWL. So have those two open for me, please.
Same thing.
They're the same color pattern. So you have that one open. And then go down.
Open me up again.
Siempre. Alright, morning Diego. Go ahead and grab a laptop for us, please. And we are sitting in the group. And then go back to the classroom. So last week, we did talk about looking up at jobs, right? Refresh me. We haven't been here since Thursday. What did we talk about last week? Or what did we introduce? Sorry. Let me clarify that. Are we okay, Diego?
Hello.
The bed? So you guys all made some awesome connections, especially Gabby. You talked about going to a retail store, right? And then Kevin, you talked about doing paperwork. Audrey, you talked about interview. And then Diego, you mentioned about doing good. And you mentioned about a process, right? So a little bit of overview for today. Our objective is we will be given information on what a job posting consists of. You guys will be using the internet to explore jobs that align with your interests. And you will write three jobs that interest you at the end of this section. We'll be assessing you using criteria A, so knowing and understanding, making sure we're using the right wide range of terminology and context. So for your startup, Diego, are you in the classroom yet? I got a thumbs up, thumb down. So everybody make sure we are opening the KWL slides that I posted. The one that you have under the tab cap. Andrew, you have those open as well. So do we know what KWL stands for? those open. So the kit is, what do you know? We were gonna talk about, what do we know about job postings? The second one's gonna be, W is, what do you want to know? And then the third one is, what did we learn about the topic? So making sure what we learned about the topic, that one we're gonna kind of save towards the end. So take about 3 minutes to go ahead and break down the first two. So what do you want to know about job postings? As well as like what you know about job postings. So K, what you know, and then W, what you want to know. So take about 3 minutes. Left.
Thank you.
seconds. Give me a thumbs up if you want another minute. Thumbs down if you guys are good to continue. Another minute?
No, I don't.
So thumbs up for another minute?
No.
Okay, thumbs down if we're good to continue. You, Audrey?
No, I mean, this.
You're good to go? Okay.
Yeah.
You good to go, Audrey? Alright, so what are some things that we talked about that we're curious to learn about? When I tell you. Audrey, you had some
very
questions. What do you want to know? Kevin, what do you want to know? So you want to know if a job offers 2 hours, right?
Yeah.
That's a good one. Why 2 hours? Why do you want to know that's 2 hours?
I'll show you.
I'm not pretty much a 4 hour or 8 hour kind of.
You don't want to work? You don't want to work
8 hours?
Yeah.
Okay. So 4.
4 hours?
That's probably
something else for me. I said, or 4.
Or, okay. And that's totally valid. Gabby, what do you want to know? Elaborate a little bit on that?
No.
What's a young adult? Someone who's like 10?
Is that adult?
So what? What age? Give me an age number that's a young adult for you.
15.
13? 15? Do we know what the age to work is here? Yes. Do we know what the age is? You can start working at 16, but you do need a working permit to let you know that you need, that you're able to work, but you still need like your parents' consent. And then Audrey, what do you want to know? Yanni, can you sleep with the job?
No.
Was that bunny busy at the job? No, no. I know you said, you mentioned that you said your dad wants you to work part time as soon as you finish high school, right? So, well, what do you want to know about looking for a job? And you, Diego, what are some things you want to know? I know you're trying to save up money for a car. Yep, I hear that. Take a few seconds, think about it. There's no right or wrong answer to this. Gabby mentioned today is an adult. Kev wants to know, can you work 2 or 4 hour shifts? Since he doesn't want to work 8 hours, what do you want to know?
about it, and I'm gonna come back to you. Okay?
Deal.
Deal.
Alright. You, Diego, anything we can think of what you want now? Think about it, and I'll come back to you? Thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up. Yeah, no, middle.
I'll take that 50.
Well, let's move on. So, do you guys know what job postings are? Alright. So, job postings essentially, when you look online, what a job consists of. They're all very similar, but they are worded a little differently. So here I have a actual job posting for a job at Ross. Who likes Ross? No, hard crap this one. So you are gonna have specific sections to this. You're gonna have like what the job is, what do you need to do, what are the benefits, what are some like skills you need. Looking at this, looking at your slides, anything that pops up to you just in general. You're welcome to say that I can highlight it, or you're welcome to go up and just highlight it, whatever pops up to you. So take about 2 minutes.
Highlight?
Yeah, is there anything that pops up?
Can you make it bigger?
Let's see.
¿Qué es la vergüenza, tío?
I think that's the biggest thing. Just go ahead and go look at your slides. And it should be there as well, so you guys can see the table. Oh, the other one? Sorry.
Yeah, which one? The first slide or the second slide? Or
keep going down.
Oh!
Okay.
Hello.
On my spot.
What is it? That's just
this
one? Yeah. Why does that pop up to you?
Because that's the role.
That's the role? Alright. Anything else that pops up? Alright, go. Anything that pops up to you? Carolyn.
Hello.
Gabby. What pops up to you? Audrey talked about a role. You want to know what position you're applying for, right?
Yeah.
You don't want to be working in the fitting room and then you're like, I have to apply for this. Doesn't?
Mm-hmm.
You're just trying to get that money?
Of course.
You're talking about the ability to occasionally push, pull, and lift more than 25 pounds. Why is that important to you, Kat? Or what did that stand out to you?
Mistake.
The what?
Heavy lifting.
So, heavy lifting. Do we want that for a job?
Not definitely.
So, no. Don't pull those out. What about you, Kev? What stands out to you?
I don't see it yet.
This clink.
Yeah, I don't see it.
So we got the role. Gabby talked about heavy lifting. Audrey says she doesn't want to do heavy lifting.
Yeah, hold on. How can I even see that?
You're welcome to get up and look at it over here. Or you wouldn't do that in there. But let me see my picture. Thank you. Diego, anything that stands out to you? Of words that we're like, what are we looking at, right?
Yeah.
Which is fine. So now we're actually going to look at what is a job posting. Because those are going to be super important when we are looking for jobs after we graduate or within this semester. So when it comes to job postings, before we kind of jump into the online places, Gabby mentioned last week about going to the retail store. Have you guys ever gone to a store and seen non-hiring signs?
Yes.
And do you recall what those signs say to you? Besides not hiring? So go to a store. And you see non-hiring. Is that all it says, or is there all the stuff that it gives you? Have you seen any non hiring posters instead of Sir Diego? Kevin, have you seen any of those signs?
Which one?
Well, you go to a store that says not hiring?
Nope.
No? Okay. So Audrey and Gabby said they have seen it. Have you seen it, Diego? No? Okay.
Alright.
Bless you.
Ah!
Bless you. So a really popular one that I see. Bless you. The not hiring posters or the sign is going to be like McDonald's. And they usually tell you like, hey, we're hiring for this position. Starting pay is blah, blah, blah. And then these are like your benefits. Some other places to actually look at besides physically is we have the awesome power of technology, right? We have our laptop right in front of us. We could definitely look Google, you could look up part-time jobs, full-time job openings, Indeed, which another website we'll get a little bit more into details later on in the unit. As well as if you're looking for like on Google, or on an actual like website, like, I don't know, for example, the Ross website. I would walk you guys how to look through the career section. And there's Glassdoor, which is very similar to me, but like I said, we'll get in the gist of that later on in this event. So when it comes to job posting skill key terms, there's gonna be very similar terms when you look at different job postings. They might just be worded very differently, but they all mean the same. But these are gonna be kind of like the main one. So we have the purpose of a role. Based on the context of the word, can we assume or take an educated guess on what the purpose of a role will mean for a job posting?
No.
No? All right, so the purpose of a role is, you know how Audrey talked about the retail associate job duties, yada yada? Yeah. So the purpose of a role is, what are you doing? What is your job role? Which is usually gonna be on the top of a job posting, telling you what you're gonna do. After that, you are gonna have essential functions, which is a little bit more of a breakdown of what the job position entitles to. So role, essential functions, what are you doing? Competencies, that one you might not see within job postings. Some positions happen, some doesn't. It's essentially like a little bit more of a bullet point of what they're looking for in an employee. Qualifications, does anybody know what qualifications are? Yeah, for what though? If we're looking for a job, are the skills that we use for are gonna be for home, for school?
If you learn.
Okay, so stuff that we learn. What are some things that you could, stuff that you learn in school that could be transferable to a job? Evan, think about it. Diego, what are some things that we could transfer from school to a job? Be part of that?
Yep.
Yes? I got one from Gabby. Kev, Diego, Audrey.
Yes.
Would math be something important?
Yeah.
Kevin says so-so. Why so-so?
I like how
it's going. Why not?
Why
not? Okay, can I try explaining it and you let me know that's yes or no? No? Okay, okay. You and Diego, do you agree with that? That we need math for jobs? Alright. So three yeses, one. Okay, Kevin changed his mind too. So all four guesses. Yeah, so you know, we could definitely use like here, the company's requiring that, you know, the person they're looking for this position is able to communicate with customers, with like other employees, leadership, to be super friendly, respectful, cooperative, and pleasant manners. And then look, even says right here. Apply to perform basic mathematical calculations used in a retail environment, which is gonna be counting money, handing people change. As well as, on top of that, there are gonna be some physical requirements. I know Gabby pointed out about lifting heavy stuff. Some jobs are literally gonna tell you like, hey, we are looking, you're gonna be required to do X, Y, and Z. So like this one is like, you're gonna be standing 100% of your shift, being able to like register technology that the store offers, carrying 25 pounds, as well as like you gotta like clean like the customers. They drop the, I don't know, like a pet shampoo. I don't buy my pet shampoo there. But you know, you never know. And some jobs are gonna have a disclaimer which is saying like, hey, you know, we do not discriminate against like race, religion, sexual orientation. Like we're kind of open to everybody to apply. So what I'm gonna show you guys how to do is open up a new tab and go on Google for me. And I wanna do this together. So I'm gonna just have you type in Aldi. What's up?
The best supermarket.
Yeah. Alright. Audrey, you type in Aldi.
No.
Kevin, you type in Aldi in Google. Alright, Kevin.
No?
Go on Google and type in Aldi.
Hmm.
Awesome. So when we're looking for jobs, Kevin, so when it comes to looking for jobs for like the actual websites, like a company you want to apply for, like I don't know, say Gabby wants to apply for PetSmart, or for the same example we're using Aldi. Normally Google's gonna pull up the website. What's up? You got a joke? What's the joke?
Hispanic moms be like, I'm not allowed to Aldi.
Very true. You're gonna see a section that says careers. You wanna go ahead and click that bad boy. What's up? See that one more time, Kev?
I don't see it, it's not here.
Go. Okay, so for you it's not popping up, right? So let me backtrack. So go ahead and just click on the General Aldi website.
This one? The top one?
Yeah. It's gonna tell it to accept the cookies. Go ahead and accept those. Go ahead and go back.
Oh, I found my fertilizer.
Right. So, do you see on the top right corner right here that says careers? Mm-hmm. Some places are going to either have it on top, but usually, like 99% of the time, you'll also see it down here. They also have careers on here. So, go ahead and click that. It should take you to a job post that has like a fancy video of people walking around. All right, we're all there. Diego, are you on there? So we want to see if Aldi's hiring around us, right? A lot of the times they're going to tell you like how far you want to work from here. Like, do you want to work right by the house? Do you want to work like, I don't know, in the suburbs? Like, don't do that. I usually like to stay in the city, but that's just a preference. It allows you to type in your location. So do you guys have Chicago?
Yeah.
Yeah? And what distance do you guys want to put? So Audrey has 5. Gabby, how far do you want to work? 5 miles away. And then Kevin, do you want to work 50 miles away? Yeah. Oh, man.
Okay.
So 5?
No.
Well, 12? That's 15. An odd number.
25. What you got? 50 miles away. I'm not going to here. No one. Here you
go. Want to work 50 miles away from here? 5 miles? So go ahead and click the magnifying glass, which is going to search for you. Job positions. Almost, almost. Give me a thumbs up if we see we're on there.
Where?
So do we know the difference between a full-time and a part-time position?
Full-time means there are more hours.
There's on
the weeks.
Full-time, more hours.
Yeah, weekdays.
All right, and what do we know about part-time?
A few hours.
A few hours? Yeah.
Weekends?
Yeah, that could also do weekends, but you could even work full-time like in a... as like in a retail store, and you could have to work weekends as well sometimes. Usually, part-time hours in Chicago is going to be anywhere from 4 hours up to 30 hours.
30
hours? Yeah. And then full-time is anywhere from 31.5 hours and up. Especially because you are going to get benefits, so you qualify for like insurance, all the fun stuff, PTO, like paid vacation time off, part time. Some jobs do that, but it's very rare when you find that.
Vacation.
Yeah. So just go ahead and click any of the regular, the full time store associate. Yeah, just put it in real quick. So, in this one, we see that it tells you what the position, so it's gonna be your job description, right? So it's a store associate. Gabby, can you read what it says for the store associate?
What, position?
Yeah, so as a store associate, you'll be...
Okay. As a store associate, you'll be responsible for merchandising and stock prices, cashiering and cleaning to keep the store a success. You'll exchange the customer shopping experience by working in collaboration with the Aldine's team and providing exceptional customer service.
Awesome, awesome. And then, Audrey, does it tell you how many, what position type this is? Is it full-time, part-time?
Full-time.
Okay. Can we tell you how many hours you're going to work?
32 to 40 hours.
Okay, 32 to 40, and does it tell you the pay?
Yeah.
Which is?
17.
Is that a good amount?
Yeah.
All right, does it tell you anything you're going to be doing in the position?
Yes.
All right, give me shout-out one. Say that one again.
Responsibility.
Responsibilities, which is?
Of being able to perform doing good without losing one.
Okay.
What else is this? What is that accomplishment?
The what? Accommodation?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And then anything else that pops up?
No.
No. So it also tells you're going to be doing inventory, you're going to talk to customers, you're going to be cleaning. But if you go down a little bit more, is there any physical demands that we have to do on the job?
Yes.
Like?
Placing products, weighing up to 45 pounds.
So how much you gotta handle? And then is there any qualifications you need to? Is there an age range that you have to be to apply to LD?
18.
18? Okay, anything else? So who here right now could apply to Aldi if they wanted to? Who here is 18? You?
Nope.
You want to apply to Aldi? No?
Okay.
Diego, can you apply to Aldi right now? Or to Diego?
Even if Amazon,
there's an age restriction? Okay. How are we feeling about looking at, oh, actually, one last thing. Is there any education or experience you need for this position?
High school diploma.
High school diploma. So when will we have that?
Which
the
is? Summer.
The summer? Okay.
Right, spring.
Do they prefer anybody to have any experience working in retail? And then, is there any benefits that you get for being a full-time employee working there? So you get like a 401k, employee discounts, which is sometimes some companies offer you like specific discounts for working with them. And is there any other stuff, like you do see insurance, right?
Yes.
There's also like PTO time. How are you feeling about looking at that post? In the middle?
Yep.
Gabby, how are you feeling about job postings? In the middle, we're okay with it. Not too
okay.
Alright?
Yes.
You Audrey? What's that?
Okay.
You feel okay with it?
Yeah.
Diego, how are you feeling? Diego. Your leg is shaking, so I don't think that is okay. So going back to your KWL slides, I went ahead and posted three different jobs. Job number one, job number two, job number three. So take the next few minutes and see if you can find one job that interests you, write the name of it, if there is like an hourly pay, is it a full-time or a part-time? And if you're able to put the link on there of the job posting. time or?
Part time.
And then
Daniel, you have any extra match?
Extra match?
Oh, I didn't. I got him.
Yeah. Wrap up your sentence and then put your laptop away.